we have to see the capacity of parallel plate capacitor. So to determine the capacity of parallel plate capacitor, we consider the parallel plate capacitor. This parallel plate capacitor consists of two parallel plates. Suppose this is plate P1, this is plate P2. Now positive charges are given to plate P1 and negative charges are induced on the plate P2. Plate P2 is connected to the earth. Therefore, the positive charges induced on the plate P2 goes to the earth. Let E be the electric intensity due to the positive charge, and it is directed from positive charge to negative charge, means P1 to P2. This is electric intensity. And V be the potential difference between the two plates. So let A be the area of each plate, small d be the distance between two plates, Q be the charges, V be the potential difference between two plates, and E be the electric intensity, which is directed from positive charge to negative charge. Now, as we have seen that the electric intensity at a point just outside and near the charge conductor, that is E is equal to sigma upon epsilon 0, where sigma is equal to surface charge density. Surface charge density, that is sigma is equal to Q upon A, and therefore electric intensity E is equal to sigma upon epsilon 0, where epsilon 0 is the permittivity of free space, means there is no any dielectric constant or dielectric medium between the two plates, and therefore E is equal to sigma upon epsilon 0. But this sigma is equal to Q upon A, and therefore this can be written as sigma upon A epsilon 0. This is equation number 1. Now, these two plates are separated with distance small d. Plate P1 has charge positive Q, plate P2 has charge negative Q, negative charge. And therefore, there is a potential difference between the two plates. Therefore, potential difference between P1 and P2 is equal to E into D, or we can write intensity E is equal to V by D. This is equation number 2. Now, from equation 1 and 2, comparing, this is E is equal to Q upon epsilon 0 and E is equal to V upon D. Therefore, from equation 1 and 2, we can write Q upon A epsilon 0 is equal to V by D. Now, V upon Q is equal to, or Q by V, we can write Q by V is equal to A epsilon 0 upon D. But as we have said, the definition of capacity, that is, capacity is nothing but the ratio of charge to potential difference, and therefore, but C is equal to Q by V. Therefore, C is equal to A epsilon 0 upon small d. This is expression for capacity of parallel plate capacitor with dielectric as air. And now, we have to see the effect of dielectric on capacity of capacitor. Means in this case, there is no dielectric. Means dielectric is as vacuum or free space, and therefore C is equal to A epsilon 0 upon d. If there is a dielectric constant, or if there is a dielectric medium whose constant is k, then we can write C is equal to A epsilon 0 k upon d. Means the capacity of capacitor with dielectric is greater than the capacity of capacitor without dielectric. Means this capacity depend upon, thus this is for node, this capacity is directly proportional to A, means area of each plate, That is, if the area of plate increases, then capacity also increases. It depends upon C inversely proportional to small d. That is, if the distance between the two plates increases, then capacity decreases. And C is equal to A epsilon 0 K pi D. This is for dielectric medium, means C directly proportional to the K. It means that if the dielectric constant increases or the dielectric material is introduced between the two plates, then its capacity also increases. This is nothing but the capacity of parallel plate capacitor with dielectric and without dielectric. In the next topic, we will see in details the effect of dielectric on capacity and the resultant formula of capacity with dielectric.